to know not only every song, but what Prince would do, Prince never liked doing the same show. So he would always switch up songs in the middle. And you had to be alert if you were in his band. And he would all of a sudden go, you know, like, I'm not doing that song. Let's do this song. And he would make you, let's say you had to learn 10 songs. He would make you learn 20 songs to play the 10 songs, just in case one night he felt like, I'm going to go play this other song. And he made us do the same thing, by the way, in the time. That same work ethic that he put towards what he did, he instilled in us and our band, too.
Well, even during at the Super Bowl performance, which I just rewatched, he was playing other people's songs. So it wasn't even like he was promoting himself, as one of the critics said. He was just wanting to give a good show and felt, you know what? Oh, I'm going to sing somebody else's song because it's going to work better in this in this thing. I mean, that's amazing. He was more interested in, you know, I mean, for a lot of artists, that is a prime promotional vehicle, getting the Super Bowl halftime. For Prince, it was just to put on the best possible show, and he did that.
It was the best possible show, and I heard you guys talking earlier, and it seemed like almost he commanded the rain, like he almost wanted that rain to fall, and the fact that he was doing it and finally, ending up with Purple Rain as the rain is coming down, but he's not slipping, he's not falling. It's almost like he's in control of everything, and he had an amazing ability to do that.
Well, Jim, again, I'm sorry it's under these circumstances, but it's really a pleasure to talk to you. Thank you.